Blackstone Publishing presents A Season on the Wind, Inside the World of Spring Migration by Kenn Kaufman. This book is read by Kenn Kaufman. Dedication. This book is dedicated to Dr. Michael Hutchins and Dolores Cole. These two individuals had such a positive impact on conservation and Ohio that they will never be forgotten. Prologue, Pilgrims at the Gates of Sunrise. Last night they were on the move. They had been waiting. Yesterday and days before, they had been scattered in a million hiding places, biding their time. For 4 days, while cold rain pelted down, they had lurked unnoticed, waiting, resting, building their strength. But yesterday the rain had cleared and a south wind had moved in. So after sunset, as the last glow died on the western horizon, they had arisen all at once. They were a multitude of independent invaders, linked by nothing but an intense awareness, taking to the sky, swarming north. Flying through the night sky, they could see lights below, both near and distant. Vast fields of light marked Cincinnati, Dayton, Columbus, although the names meant nothing to them. Smaller patches of light glowed everywhere. But these travelers would not have considered navigating by the lights below. They looked up at lights overhead, at the stars arrayed across the black velvet dome of the sky. Those were the reliable guides. Cities, after all, might rise and fall, but the constellations overhead would persist, pointing the way for those who could read the sky. Most humans on the ground below were utterly unaware of the abundance of life passing overhead. But this springtime movement of migratory birds was nothing new. Birds had flown north across this landscape before there were any electric lights, even before there were scattered campfires. They flew before names like United States and Ohio were first used, and before any calendars called this the second week of May. They flew before the human ideas of weeks and months were invented. The routes and seasons of their travels varied over long spans of time, as sea levels rose and fell, as ice sheets advanced and retreated. But the basic movement of migration began millennia ago, its origins lost in the mist of prehistory. In the last few centuries, humans have made sweeping changes to the landscape. There is now less room for wild birds. There are fewer places for them to raise their young, and the northward spring flights are only a shadow of what they once were. But even these diminished flights are still astounding. On peak nights in spring, tens of millions of birds, representing hundreds of different species, are moving north all across the continent. During the course of the season, migrating birds fly over every square mile of land in North America, some flying north, some northeast, some northwest, mostly navigating as individuals and not as flocks. They form a living, seething layer of life far above the ground, for as long as the night lasts. Most humans are completely oblivious to the feathered parade in the night sky. But some of us are keenly aware. We have been watching weather patterns all season, looking for nights like this with prime conditions. Last night after dark, we went online to look at Doppler radar. As small as these birds are, their sheer numbers show up on weather radar, indicating to us when birds are actively moving. Later in the night, we went outdoors to listen, and we could hear the occasional flight calls of small birds drifting down from 1,000 feet in the air. And before daylight this morning, we headed out to the lakeshore, eager to be there at dawn to watch for the arriving migrants. The birds coming from the south, flying a few hundred feet up in the last hours of the night, will see hints of what lies ahead even before first daylight. Below, the velvety blackness of the land is broken only by isolated lights around farmhouses and small towns and the larger glow from distant cities. But up ahead, moonlight or starlight glints on water, a vast swath of water stretching toward the north. Humans call it Lake Erie, one of the Great Lakes. The flying birds see it miles before they reach it, and they may start to drop a little lower, as if calculating whether to end their night's journey before coming to the water's edge.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.